This shit's real, man. You ain't never had no jazz on the news. Wait. What I want to do is... Good evening. Obama shot Bin Laden today. Welcome to the evening news, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the news. And then I'm playing jazz. Then I'm gonna do my thing. But ain't nobody ever done this. This is something new.
Thank you.
I think that some of my great influences musically was Thelonious Monk, who's born in the same hometown I was born in, Rocky Mount, North Carolina. Thelonious Monk was born in Rocky Mount, and I was born in Rocky Mount. And I didn't meet him in New York. I met Harold Vick, who was my teacher, one of my teachers. And yeah, Thelonious Monk. And then my most greatest influence was Herbie Hancock. He played my first song that I ever wrote. Herbie Hancock was my greatest piano influence in the world. And he played my song on RCA Records when I was 18. And I wrote a song when John Coltrane died that day. I was 18. And I just saw John Coltrane the night before he died. The Village Vanguard. He was 39 and I was 18. And I wrote the song that night called Ode to Train. And musicians call him Train. Next day I was in the studio hanging out with Harold Vick. And the drummer was Grady Tate. And the bass player was Bob Crenshaw. And they were doing a jazz session with Herbie Hancock. I think it was called Watch What Happens, RCA session. And Vic and I rode, took a ride to the studio, and they recorded. And Herbie Hancock looked at my song that I wrote called Ode to Train. And he said, yeah. And Harold Vick was a saxophone player, and they played it right in front of me. And he said, that's a nice tune, Ode to Train. And Herbie Hancock played it. My first tune on RCA Records. RCA Records? Boy, I was proud that day. So Herbie was my biggest influence as far as being a jazz man and a piano. He's probably my biggest influence. McCoy is different. He's a spiritual kind of man. He's different kind of existence. Herbie's pianistically conscious. He knows what's going on all around. McCoy is a different kind of man. So between those two, those are my influences. And I respect both of them.
Thank you. When I was 8 years old, I was in the third grade. We had a paper in our school, and I was 8 years old, and they had a paper called Current Events for the children in the school. And I was in the school, and I was 8 years old, 1955. And my teacher said, you gotta read this paper every day. When we go to class in school, our teacher showed me this newspaper for children. It said Current Events. It was not a newspaper, it was just a cheap little children's school paper. And one day my teacher came in and said, I want you to look at this. It's called Current Events in the newspaper. We pass it out for the children. And there was a picture of Charlie Parker on the front. He died that morning. Current Events. It was Charlie Parker's picture right on the front. And she saw it to me. She said, look, that's the saxophone player that just died today. I said, who the hell is that? Charlie Parker. Current Events. What a hell of a story.